In this video, I am going to show you how to make a 3D larynx model, building a model of all the laryngeal cartilages and muscles is the best way to learn vocal anatomy. And if you watch until the end, I will tell you where to get a template to this model for free. Stay tuned. Hi, I'm Katarina, speech-language pathologist from How to Improve Singing, and here on this channel I share practical tips about using your voice in a healthy way. So, if this is a topic that interests you, consider subscribing to this channel and hitting that bell notification icon so that you don't miss any of my future videos. In my previous video, I was talking about vocal anatomy and I showed you a few pictures and videos so that you can actually visualize the intricate anatomy of the larynx. But there is nothing better than touching a 3D model of the larynx to really understand how the structures relate to each other. So I decided to test my crafting skills. And today I am making a 3D model of the larynx. This is what you'll need to make this model. A template, cardstock paper that is thicker than normal paper, but you can also use foam if you have that at home. You can use either white paper, but I recommend colored paper. Then you'll need a pencil, scissors, glue or a tape, an elastic thread or band, a big needle, and round metal brads. Step number one, print out the template and cut all the pieces out. Then trace them either on colored or white cardstock paper. If you have a crafting foam, you can use that too. Then cut all the pieces out. Step 2. The biggest cartilage is the thyroid cartilage. Fold it in half. In men, this is the part that sticks out and we know it as the Adam's apple. Here is the thyroid notch, superior and inferior horns and lamina, which are the flat sides of the thyroid cartilage. You can watch my previous video to learn how to find all these anatomical structures on yourself. I will put a link to that video below. Step 3. Epiglottis is the cartilage that is attached to the thyroid cartilage on the inside. Tape it to the thyroid cartilage below the thyroid notch on the inside. Thank you.
Step 4. Tape the cricoid cartilage together to form a circle. My cricoid cartilage is pretty in pink. It looks like a ring, a giant ring in this model. The back part of the cricoid cartilage is broader than the front part. Step 5. Here we are going to attach the inferior horns of the thyroid cartilage. Attach the thyroid cartilage to the cricoid cartilage with the round metal brads. Carefully cut or puncture holes through the cricoid cartilage and the inferior horns of the thyroid cartilage. Then thread the metal brads through the holes and fasten them by opening the tips. Looking good! Step 6. Now it's time to put the arytenoid cartilages in place together with the vocal ligaments. First, strengthen the vocal processes of the arytenoid cartilages with a piece of tape. We will be attaching an elastic string to these parts. Cut a piece of elastic string or thread, which is going to represent the vocal ligament found in the vocal folds. Thread it through a big needle. Then attach one end of the string to one of the arytenoids. Then, puncture a hole through the thyroid cartilage below the thyroid notch. Now, thread the elastic string back through the thyroid cartilage and attach the other end to the second arytenoid cartilage. Give the elastic thread some tension, but don't overstretch it. Place the arytenoids on the back portion of the cricoid cartilage. And voila, here is a 3D model of the larynx. Now let's explore some of the movements and relationships between some of these structures. When you swallow, the epiglottis comes down and closes the entrance to the breathing tube to prevent food from entering it. Now, when you breathe in and out, the vocal folds abduct, move away from each other, and if you remember from my previous video, the only abductor are the posterior cricoarytenoid muscles, which originate on the cricoid cartilage and attach to the arytenoids here at the back. On the other hand, when we produce voice sounds, the arytenoids slide closer together, which causes the vocal folds to meet in the midline so that they can start vibrating. Now, finally, let's look at how the cricothyroid muscle, or the CT muscle, affects the tension of the vocal ligament or the vocal folds themselves. So you would find the CT muscle here at the front, and when they contract, the thyroid cartilage rocks forward, or the space between the cricoid cartilage and the thyroid cartilage gets smaller. Look what it does to the vocal ligament. The vocal folds get longer and tenser.
And that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. Click this link if you want to download the template for free and make your own larynx model. Check out my previous video on vocal anatomy to find all the structures and more on your own neck. I will see you soon. Bye.